Hello students, today I will discuss the basics of simple machines. At first, we have to know what is a machine. A device which is capable of doing useful work is known as machine. Generally, machines are two types, simple machine and compound machine. Now, what is a simple machine? A simple machine may be defined as a device which enables us to do some useful work at some point or to overcome some resistance when an effort or force is applied to it at some other convenient point. These are some examples of simple machines. Now, what is a compound machine? A compound machine may be defined as a device consisting of a number of simple machines, which enables us to do some useful work at a faster speed or with a much less effort as compared to a simple machine. These are some examples of compound machines. What is load? Any weight which is lifted by a machine is known as load, which is denoted by capital W. And what is effort? The force required by a machine to lift the load or to displace the load is known as effort, and that is denoted by capital P. In the figure, W is the load and P is the effort. By applying the effort P, we can lift the load W. Mechanical advantage. The mechanical advantage is the ratio of the weight lifted to the effort applied. Thus, mechanical advantage is equal to capital W by capital P, where capital W is the weight lifted and capital P is the effort applied. Velocity ratio. The velocity ratio is the ratio of the distance moved by the effort, which is denoted by small y, to the distance moved by the load, which is denoted by small x. Therefore, velocity ratio is equal to y by x, that is distance moved by the effort to the distance moved by the load. Efficiency of a machine. The efficiency of a machine is the ratio of output to the input of a machine. It is given by efficiency, which is denoted by eta, is the ratio between output by input, that is output by input into 100. Relation between mechanical advantage, velocity ratio and efficiency. The input of a machine is given by effort applied multiplied by distance through which the effort has removed. Since capital P is the effort applied and small y is the distance to which the effort has moved, so that we can write the input of a machine is equal to capital P into small y. Output of a machine, which is given by load lifted multiplied by distance to which the load has been lifted, which is equal to capital W into x, where capital W is the load lifted and small x is the distance to which the load has been lifted. And since the efficiency eta is the ratio of output and input, so that instead of output we can write capital W into x and instead of input we can write P into y. And by rearranging the equation we can write capital W by capital P divided by small y by small x. Since W by P, that is the ratio between weight lifted and the effort applied, is the mechanical advantage, so that instead of W by P, we can write mechanical advantage, and y by x, which is the ratio between the distance through which the effort has moved to the distance through which the load has been lifted, is velocity ratio. So instead of y by x, we can write Vr, that is the velocity ratio. So the efficiency eta becomes the ratio between mechanical advantage and velocity ratio. Reversibility of a machine. A machine is also capable of doing some work in reverse direction after the effort is removed. Such a machine is called a reversible machine. The action of such machine is known as reversibility of the machine. For a reversible machine, efficiency should be more than 50%. Self-locking or non-reversible machine. When a machine is not capable of doing any work in the reverse direction after the effort is removed, is called non-reversible or self-locking machine. The action of such a machine is known as non-reversibility of the machine. For a non-reversible or self-locking machine, the efficiency should be less than 50%. Ideal machine. If the efficiency of a machine is 100%, that is, the output is equal to input, the machine is called an ideal machine. Or when a machine is absolutely free from frictional resistance, then the machine is called ideal machine. For an ideal machine, efficiency must be 100%. We know that the efficiency is the ratio between the output and input. For an ideal machine, 100% is equal to output by input. Since 100% means 1, so that we can write that is output equal to input. So instead of output, we can write capital W into small x, and instead of input, we can write capital P into small y. By rearranging the equation, we can write capital W by capital P is equal to small y by small x. And since W by P is the mechanical advantage and small y by small x is the velocity ratio, so that for an ideal machine, mechanical advantage is equal to velocity ratio. Law of a machine. Law of a machine may be defined as the relationship between the load lifted and the effort applied. If we record the various values of efforts required to raise the corresponding loads and plot a graph between effort and load, we shall get a straight line AB, which represents the law of machine. In the figure, the effort P is along the y-axis and the load W is along x-axis. And the straight line AB represents the law of machine. So, according to the equation of straight line, which is y equal to mx plus c, we can write the law of machine P equal to mw plus c, where P is the effort applied to lift the load, small m is a constant which is known as coefficient of friction, and which equals to the slope of the line AB. Capital W is the load lifted and C is a constant which represents the machine friction. Maximum mechanical advantage. We know that mechanical advantage of a lifting machine, that is MA, is equal to weight lifted by effort applied, that is capital W by capital P. For maximum mechanical advantage, the machine must follow the law of machine, that is P equal to MW plus C. So, for maximum mechanical advantage, we can write instead of capital P, MW plus C. So, the equation becomes MA max is equal to capital W divided by MW plus C. By dividing the numerator and denominator by capital W, we get 1 by M plus C by W. And since C by W is very small, so that it can be neglected. So, the equation of maximum mechanical advantage becomes 1 by M. Maximum efficiency of a lifting machine. We know that the efficiency of a lifting machine, eta, is equal to mechanical advantage by velocity ratio. We also know that the mechanical advantage of a lifting machine is the ratio between the weight lifted to the effort applied, that is the W by P. So that instead of mechanical advantage, we can write capital W by capital P. By rearranging, the equation becomes efficiency eta is equal to capital W divided by capital P into VR, that is the velocity ratio. For maximum efficiency, the machine must follow the law of machine, that is P equal to MW plus C. So, for maximum efficiency, instead of P, we can write MW plus C. So, the equation becomes maximum efficiency eta max is equal to capital W divided by MW plus C into VR. Now, dividing the numerator and the denominator by capital W, we can get eta max is equal to 1 divided by M plus C by W into VR. Since the value of C by W is very small, so that it can be neglected, so the ultimate equation of maximum efficiency becomes eta max is equal to 1 divided by small m into VR. Thank you, students, for listening to the lecture.